Welcome back to my channel. Thank you for watching the video. So I'm just gonna jump right into it. Today we're going to talk about skincare, which is one of my favorite topics of all time. I do love makeup, but I feel that as I have gotten older and, you know, more sort of aware of my surroundings and how they impact your skin, I've become very, very, very much invested in skincare, probably more than makeup. Any of you who know me know that I'm sort of borderline insane about skincare and protecting my skin, making sure that I don't have to resort to surgical methods or even non-surgical invasive methods, Botox, anything before I really, really have to. Now, I'm 32 years old, but I want to make sure that I can sort of hold off on aging of the skin for as long as I can. I know that everyone tells you that you should ideally start using anti-aging skincare, anti-aging products when you're 25. I did not. And I can tell you from experience and from my heart that I wish that I did, because I really, really think that it makes a major difference if you start looking after your skin when it's at its peak, which would be, of course, when you're a teenager, if you don't have acne, if you're lucky, or in your early 20s, you can really, really prevent aging, sagging of the skin, spots, pigmentation, all of these things at a younger age, and really keep them at bay for as long as you need. Now, I'm lucky. My mom has great skin. All of her sisters have great skin. People on my dad's side have great skin. So I'm kind of like, I don't have issues like acne or too much hair on my face, or even, you know, like getting wrinkles at an early age. And I'm only 32, so I don't really know about the wrinkles, but my mom didn't really get wrinkles until she hit 50, so knock on wood. But at the same time, I live in an area where the climate is really not ideal. It's the middle of the desert, basically. I live in Dubai. So I think ever since I really moved here, I understood how important it was to take care of your face. I've been rambling on about this for about 20 minutes now. Let's get to what the video is about. This video is about the fad that is Korean skincare. Unless you're living under a rock, you know that Korean skincare has become like this super popular topic and trend for everyone to talk about. And I don't know if it's a fad, but I totally got sucked into it, and I started doing research about Korean skincare, I think at the beginning of last year. Now, that's another thing, I'm a big research person about skincare, so I'm constantly reading up on new things, new ideas, natural ways to improve your skin, because that's something that I'm really, really into. And that was also something that kind of drew me to reading more about Korean skincare, because they do use a lot of products. Well, a lot of the base products are nature-based, like, you know, the snail creams or the seaweed or stuff like that. So long story short, I started reading about it. I was really into it. My friend was planning a trip to Seoul. My friend was planning a trip to Seoul in South Korea, and I jumped at the opportunity to go and really get immersed in the whole beauty culture there in person. So we did that in November of last year, and it was awesome. I really got to see how crazy people really are for beauty there, and really, you know, walk into the store and speak to the salespeople, who were so informative, as well as we could because of the language barrier. And yeah, really just experienced the products for myself. Now, I will say that before I went, I did extensive research and really narrowed down on the products that I wanted to try. I didn't want to go there and be overwhelmed and not really know what to get, and then end up getting stuff that didn't really suit my skin or didn't have great reviews or didn't, you know, go through the trial and errors that really good skincare should go through. So I knew what I wanted. I had a list of things that I wanted to try. I had a list of brands that I knew I wanted to try. There were two things I was considering. One was products that were not too expensive, easy on the wallet, and two, products that would really, you know, target my problem areas. So I'll start by telling you guys about my skin type. My skin type is combination, but it's more leaning towards the oily side. So my T-zone is definitely very, very oily, and I do have a huge issue with pores. So I have very large pores around my nose. I have some small ones here, and maybe, I mean, I used to have some here, but they've kind of gone away. But definitely around my nose area, and this area, I have a lot of pores, and they do get very gunky. And again, like I mentioned about the climate and the atmosphere here where I live, they do get clogged and they do get really gross. My cheeks are quite dry. Now, I have noticed that the combination used to be like in very high contrast. Like my T-zone used to be very, very oily, and my cheeks used to be very dry, especially after I washed them. But I have noticed since I started using this combination of products that my skin is really no longer dry, and the oil is mostly kept at bay. So they're definitely effective. So that's my skin type. It's combination with pores. And I will say that do not go out into the sun at all. I avoid it as much as I can. And number one is because I hate feeling hot. But number two is because I'm so careful about wrinkles from the sun and, you know, like all these issues like skin cancer. I know you're not going to get skin cancer from sitting out in the sun, but you could. I mean, that's how people get it. I don't know. You get what I mean, though. But so I don't go out into the sun, and I do wear sunscreen as often as I can. I haven't been able to find a sunscreen that really suits my skin. I feel like I found one that was really great, and that was Bioderma, which wasn't too oily or too thick, the milk. But sadly for me, because I do have the darker skin, I felt it left a white film over my face, so not gonna have that. So yeah, that's my skin type. I'm still talking about it. That's my skin type. Number two I wanted to talk about is a 10-step Korean skincare regime that I'm sure most of you have heard about, and it's what people, it's the 10 steps that Korean women use every night and probably every morning to really get their skin looking like it does. And let me tell you, I saw them, the men and the women, their skin looks like porcelain. It's like you could touch it and you would make it dirty. They are perfect. So you can tell that they work hard on this. So the 10 steps, basically, I'll just tell you quickly what they are. So it starts with cleansing, a cleansing oil, and then a cleanser, a proper cleanser, like a lathering one. And then you go on to a toner, a serum, an essence, an emulsion, a sheet mask, if you want to do a sheet mask every night, a thick moisturizer, an eye cream, and I'm missing the last one. I swear I wrote this down and I can't remember it. A sleeping pack, an ampoule maybe? Anyway, basically it's just layers and layers and layers of things to moisturize your skin and things to help propel the moisturizer into your skin to go deeper. I do not do 10 steps. I mean, I do most of the steps, but I don't do 10 because I feel like this combination of products that I am using is really, really ideal for me. I don't want to overdo it. And if this is working, you know, like if it ain't broke, why fix it? So I'll tell you guys what I start with. Oh, shoot, I forgot my wipes. Okay, so basically, when I have, it really depends on how much makeup I'm wearing during the day. If I'm wearing a lot of makeup, I use just virgin coconut oil to, like, I rub it all over my face to break up the makeup and really cleanse it up. And then I use a makeup wipe to remove it. I use the Johnson's face care wipes, which they're in my bathroom. I'm honestly too lazy to get up and get them. But I use those to wipe off the coconut oil. And if I still feel, because I do wear a lot of I wear very dark eyeliner and mascara, if I feel like I still have some, I just use the Bioderma water to wipe it off with a cotton pad. But most days, like right now, I just wear I don't wear foundation every day. I wear concealer and a little bit of blush. I draw in my eyebrows, and I have eyeliner and mascara, so basically everything else but foundation, which is what, for reference, that's what I'm wearing right now. I have concealer, I have some blush, and eyebrow pomade, and eyeliner. So this is what my skin looks like without foundation. Where was I? Oh yeah, so I use the makeup wipes to remove my makeup, and then I use a cleanser. Okay, now I'm gonna have to get up because I forgot to get the cleanser. 1 second. I was nice and I bought the makeup wipes too. So these are the ones I use, just Johnson's and Johnson's. Just the Johnson's face care wipes. These are for normal to combination skin hydration essential. So they're nice because they don't like make your skin feel too stripped. So this is the face wash that I use after I have cleansed, like pre-cleansed my face. And it's the Innisfree Green Tea Cleansing Foam. Innisfree is one of the more popular Korean skincare brands. They literally have a store on every corner, so you could walk into any store and get whatever you want. And I will tell you, they have bomb selection of products. Not only a selection of products, but their products are great. So this face wash I bought on the recommendation of one of the sales girls. And I just told her what kind of skin I had and she gave me this. So this is the green tea cleansing foam. It is enriched with squeezed green tea from Jeju Island to deliver abundant moisture and nourishment deep into your skin. This is, honestly, I'm not kidding, it's the best face wash I have ever used. It's so thick, you just need like less than a pea. I swear I use this much, like that much. And you just, your face is damp, you rub it all over your face, and when you take it off, your skin is already glowing. You might feel like you don't even need to do the rest of the steps. It really does take everything off. I will say that I do pre-cleanse, so I don't know how it is at removing makeup, but your face wash is really not what you should be using to remove makeup. So yeah, it makes my skin at least feel really glowy, look really glowy after I wash with it. And I think for me the biggest thing is that my skin does not feel oily, nor does it feel like tight and stripped after I'm done washing my face. And that's a big thing for me, because I feel like if it's tight, it gives me like heebie-jeebies. So the face wash is a definite yes for me. I've had this one, I've been using it since November. I've been using this since December now, and it's March, and I use it twice a day. And I still have half of it left, so that's testament to how little of it you really need. Again, it's awesome. The thing about Innisfree is that they, you know, there's no animal testing, there's no parabens in their products, so it's really quite natural. And they grow all of their products, actually. So they probably grow the green tea that they are using to make this. Yeah, Jeju Squeeze green tea. So they do everything, you know, the brand does everything itself. It's growing them, it's extracting everything that you need itself. So it's really, I think that puts me at ease that, okay, there's not a lot of scientific crap in it. There probably is, but whatever. Okay, so I use that to wash my face. After I wash my face, I use a toner. Now, I don't use a chemical toner. I use rose water as a toner. This is just pure rose water. It's a Pakistani rose water. I think it's the Kirshi one. I get it from a Pakistani store here. Oops, excuse me. I just put in the spray bottle from Daiso. I just spray this onto my face after I cleansed. Now, if you know the benefits of rose water, you know that it is, of course, it's very refreshing for your face. It also works as a sunblock, and it helps cleanse the skin. So, you know, it really almost serves as an antibacterial. And aside from that, rose water is also anti-aging. So perfect. What else do we need? So after the rose water, I use this, guys. This is the thing. This is what you need. So I use the Time Revolution, the first treatment essence mist. You might have heard about this before. This is from Misha. Now this is just a spray. You just spray it onto your face after the toner. And this is actually comparable or a dupe for the SK2 essence that I'm sure you've seen, you know, everywhere, which is ridiculously expensive. I think it's around $100 for a bottle. This is literally probably like $25. Basically, what an essence does is it prepares your skin for application of moisturizers. It basically prepares your skin in the sense that it opens it up, so the moisturizers or anything that comes after this is really absorbed into your skin. So this is a very important part of the skincare regime, because it is basically giving your moisturizers and your serums an open canvas and something that your skin needs, because what is the point of applying all of these things if they're really not absorbing into it? So I guess you could say that this is an agent that helps the moisturizers and the serums really accomplish what they need to do. This is amazing. This is something that I use without fail every day. I don't skip the step, and sadly I have run out of it because maybe I go overboard. But this is from Misha, which is a great brand. It's available online, and for real, if you're only going to do about 3 or 4 steps, this has to be one of them, because I can tell you that after I apply this, after I apply stuff on top of it, I can feel that it's absorbed immediately. Maybe in 10 or 15 minutes. Like I said, I have very thick, very oily skin, so things take a long time to really get into it anyway, but this has definitely made a difference, and I feel like it's one of the things that if I don't use it, I can see that other things are working differently. So this is definitely a must-have. So it's the Misha the first time essence mist. I have the mist. You can also buy just the essence, which doesn't come in a spray bottle, but I would actually go for that, because my friends have that one and I got this. But that one is better in the sense that you can it's gonna last you a lot longer, because you know with the spray you kind of go crazy like I do, and I but with essence, you know how much you're using. Okay, I'm just gonna flip my hair this way, because this weird thing is like, why? It's weird because I have like a bald spot and then I have this. Like, this should be back here. I don't get it. Okay, next we have, this is by Laneige. This is by Laneige, and this is the Essential Balancing Emulsion Moisture. So this is an emulsion, which is the easiest way to explain what an emulsion is just, it's a lightweight moisturizer. It's water-based. This one is water-based at least. And everything is in Korean, so I have no idea what the bottle says. But this is basically, I use this on top of the essence, and it's beautiful. It smells great. It's a great texture, very light, very airy almost, even though it is a moisturizer. And the emulsion basically serves as a layer of moisturization for your face, and you put it on at night. I also use this, this is what I use in the morning as a moisturizer. I don't use the thick cream because it's too much. And then after that we have, this is my favorite product, this thing, like I can't, I'm just gonna, this is it. So oh my god, okay, I'm back. This is the Innisfree Soybean Energy Oil. I had no idea what this was. I had actually not read about this. I had read about everything else that I bought, but I had not read about this. I had no idea what it was. The sales girl at the Innisfree shop obviously knew that I was crazy and looking for shit to buy for no reason. So you just need about 2 or 3 drops of this. I zoomed out a little. So you just need 2 or 3 drops of this, you know, just on your fingertips, and I just tap it into my face. Usually I just mix this with a pump of the emulsion, mix them together and tap it into my face. When I'm feeling a little fancy, I use maybe 4 or 5 drops of it and do it. I don't know. Instantly, you will feel your skin getting plumper, getting tighter in a good way. Looking smooth and clean. Like, one of the things I noticed maybe a week after was the tightness here. Like, I mean, you can see, like I said, I'm not wearing foundation, I'm wearing highlighter, but you can see like there's this beautiful sort of glow here, like where you would highlight, there's a glow here. I mean, it's like my cheeks feel so smooth and plump. Like, it's given me reason not to wear makeup every day. I mean, it's one of those things that I feel like this is the star product. This is the thing that has changed my life. I'm not even being dramatic. So the soybeans that they use, Innisfree uses in this line, is grown by them on Jeju Island. It's nurtured by them, it's fermented by them, it's the things, the minerals that they need are extracted by them, and then it's put into these beautiful products. I haven't used anything else from the line, but I definitely will be. I want to try other things because for me, this is the star product. The minerals extracted from soybeans act as antioxidants and they act as anti-aging agents. So obviously these are all things that I'm looking for, but for me, this is a miracle worker and it just blew me away. And I will tell you the price. It is literally like $28 or $30. And I don't know if it's available on Amazon, but you can definitely find it. I'll link it below into the website that I found it, that ships to the UAE and it ships to other countries. So if you're in Lahore, if you're in Dubai, you can definitely find it. So that's my baby right there. After I use the face oil at night is when I use the moisturizer. This is the Laneige Water Bank Moisture Cream. This is a beautiful moisturizer, actually. It's quite creamy. It's thick. It's definitely thick. This is something that I started using every day, but I do not use it every day now. I use it every other day because it's actually quite thick and I don't want my pores to start getting clogged up by having too much stuff on them. So I felt that it works for me better this way, but if you have drier skin, I would definitely say you can use this every day, morning and night. But for me, it's a beautiful moisturizer. It smells really great. It works well with the other products, especially emulsion, because it's the same line. It's the Water Bank emulsion. So yeah, that's my moisturizer. I also have the Laneige lip sleeping mask, which is it's gorgeous. It smells like apple. I haven't really used this. I'll tell you why, because I'm too obsessed with my Burt's Bees chapstick, which I like to wear before I go to bed. So I keep neglecting this, but the few times I used it, I thought it was great. It smells really good and it's very, very thick. So I feel like if you sleep on it, you know, when you sleep, your skin cells regenerate, and that's why you should be careful about the things you put on your face while you sleep, because that's when your skin is working to get better. So that's probably why this is a sleeping mask for your lips and not just a balm to use daily during the day, which you could, but I mean, it's very thick. I don't think you can. I lied. I don't know why I said that. The other things that I have, which I feel work well as well, they're not a part of the daily routine. They're just a few masks that I got because I do really, really, really love sheet masks. I think they're great. I don't do one every day, I do one once a week, but I feel that you could do one maybe every 2 days, just depending on your skin type and the type of mask you're doing. But for me, you know, the way my skin is looking and it's feeling, once a week is sufficient. Don't know English anymore. So this is another Innisfree product that I use. This is the Super Volcanic Pore Clay Mask. And it's literally, that's what it is, a clay mask. It's for your pores. I just use this on my T-zone. I don't use it on my whole face. The Volcanic Clay Mask is another Jeju Island product, which is Innisfree's clay, basically. And it's really good. Washes off great. I did notice, I've only used this about 4 or 5 times, but I have noticed after each time that the pores are definitely looking good. They're looking smaller. They're looking, they're looking like they've been cleaned of their gunk. Now, I will say very honestly here that I also use the, the Indian Healing Clay. And for me, that's way more effective. I know they're both different masks and this has a different function and that has a different function. But if you have skin like me, then the Indian Healing Clay Mask, which is the powder that you mix with, you can mix it with water or apple cider vinegar. That's definitely more effective in pulling out the crap from your pores. So that's the one mask I got from there. This surprised me that I didn't really go crazy with the sheet masks, because I feel like that's such, you know, like a Korean thing. So, but the ones that I did get, I really just wanted to get stuff that was more targeted. So I wasn't trying 10,000 different things and, not really understanding what was working for me, which is a reason that I'm making this video now. you know, like 4 or 5 months after I've been using the products, because I've understood what combinations and what steps really work for me. So these are the two sheet masks that I have. They're both from Misha. And one is a collagen sheet mask, because as I told you, I'm trying to look 25 forever. And one is the AHA BHA sheet mask. This one is effin bomb. AHA BHA, we both know, alpha hydroxy acids and beta hydroxy acids. They are natural acids, which are for texture of the skin, for brightening the skin. If you have any sort of, you know, issues like with uneven skin tone or texture, which I did, I had quite a bit of texture on my cheeks just from, I think it's from using the derma roller. I think that totally screwed up my skin. It was not for me. So I had some texture on my cheeks from that. I didn't really use a glycolic acid or any sort of acid on my face, any serum, nothing, but I did use these. So where was I? So yeah, I have used this, and I will say, when you put it on your face, so I'm crazy, I leave them on for an hour, I don't leave them on for 20 minutes. It's amazing. You can feel your skin tingling, and when you take it off, it's just like this smooth, glowing, I don't know, perfect face. I love it so much. I got 20 packs of each of these, and these are my last ones, so I have no idea what I'm left to do with my life. Yeah, so those are the sheet masks I got. I didn't get any other sheet masks. I don't want to. I'm happy with these. I want to keep using them. If you guys know of any other ones that you feel are better, if you've tried these in comparison, I would love to know. I would love to try them. I also got these gel eye patches. I don't love them. They're very slidey, so I don't think the gel eye patches are okay for me. I think I need like the ones that stick onto your eyes. But yes, so those are the products that I use. Those are the products that I'm happy with in this combination. There are some things that I would like to add into my arsenal, and one of those things is a really good exfoliator, because I don't have that, and as summer approaches in Dubai, it's going to get really, really sticky and gross and lots of sand. So I would love to have an exfoliator to really clean out my skin and get rid of, like, slough off the dead skin and get rid of the gunk. And I definitely want to add an eye cream into the mix, which is something that it was on my list and I totally just blinked out and I forgot to get one. But I want to try a Korean one. I don't want to try any other one, just because I feel like it's really working for me. I've tried other moisturizers. I've tried other things for my face washes, you know, overnight things, but I just feel like these work for me, and I'm a big advocate of using natural stuff on your face. And so I know that they're not completely natural, but there are a lot of base products which are natural, and that makes me happy. And of course, because, you know, we're all not millionaires, they're really, really, really easy on the wallet. I think all of these combined would be maybe even under $200, which is great. And they've lasted me for 4 months now, so I think that's definitely worth a buy. If you've used any of these products, I would love to hear your feedback. I would also love to hear any advice from any of you on what skincare works for you. So yeah, that's my take on the Korean skincare fad. I don't think it's a fad. I think there's definitely something there. They're definitely way ahead in terms of advancing with products and different types of products. And you know what? It might be a little high maintenance for some people, because it does take about 20 minutes in the morning and at night, but it's your skin. It's worth it. It's your face. If you have perfect skin, if you even have great skin, you don't need to do, you know, and for me, it's fine. I think it's worth the sacrifice of the 20 minutes every night and day, because I think great skin is it's hard to achieve, and if you haven't actually, I hate you and I love you, but some of us have to work for it, so I'm working for it. That's it. There's a lot of shit I just spewed out, but yes, thank you for watching, and I shall be back soon. Toodles.